Hi guys, let's make the tastiest chicken shawarma ever. Now I use chicken breast. This is the best part of the chicken to use for your chicken shawarma. I marinated mine in chicken spice and other ingredients. I'm going to put a list in the description box. You don't have to marinate, you can just spice and go ahead and start frying. So in a hot pan, put some oil and then dump your chicken inside. Turn it. I like to fry mine until golden brown because you know I'm Nigerian, we like to go the extra mile. So you keep turning it until it turns golden brown like so. This is what it should look like when you're done. Now, this is one step some people miss, the onions. I use caramelized onions and I use vegetable oil and sesame oil to caramelize my onions. So in a pan, put the oils, put the onions and then fry until golden brown. Trust me, it won't taste like raw onions that people don't like to have in their shawarma. This has a very distinct taste that adds to the taste of your shawarma. This is what it should look like when you're done. Next step is to fry your sausages or chicken franks. In a pan of oil, put your sausages or chicken franks. Flip them occasionally to avoid burning and this is what they should look like when they are ready. Put them in a paper towel to drain and now it's time for the veggies. For the veggies, I'm using cabbage and carrots. The onions have already been caramelized. I'm going to be using just half of this medium bulb. So you shred your cabbages to any size that you want. This is medium size, just the way I like them. Next, you grate your carrots. I don't use as much carrots as the cabbages. There's really no math to this. It's just my personal preference and I'm sure you will like it too. This is what the carrots should look like when you're done grating them. Next is the chicken breast. I really wanted them to be tinier than what they were already, so I just shredded them a little bit more. Again, this is personal preference. Now to the sauce. This is where you can make or break your shawarma. I like to use mayonnaise, tomato ketchup and sweet chili sauce. Do not skip these guys. In a bowl, combine your mayonnaise. Add enough, guys. It's better to have more than for you to have less. You can easily make a sandwich later with the extra sauce. Then you add your tomato ketchup and also add your sweet chili sauce. I also like to add scotch bonnet pepper to mine. It makes it really tasty and spicy. Scotch bonnet pepper is a regular red pepper or atarodo. Mix thoroughly and you'll get this bright peach color that looks so good. Now it's time to assemble your shawarma. I like to decant some for you to rub on the shawarma bread to make sure that it sticks properly. You will see that later on in the video. Then in the sauce bowl, I put my cabbage and next goes in the carrot. I prefer to mix everything together before wrapping. So after the carrot, I put my caramelized onions. Guys, don't skip this part please. Then comes the star of the show, the chicken breast. So combine everything thoroughly, mix and make sure no part is left out. Now this is what your mixture should look like when you're done mixing properly. Now it's wrapping time. You can use shawarma bread, pita bread, naan bread or anyone you can find in the regular supermarkets. Trust me, they're not scarce at all. You can find them even in small supermarkets. Now remember the sauce that we decanted earlier? You put it on the shawarma bread and you rub it generously all around the shawarma bread. This helps it to stick properly and to avoid spillage. After coating your shawarma bread evenly with the sauce, next you put your chicken and veggies mix and then you put your sausage and it's time to wrap. Guys, pay close attention to this stage. Now you start wrapping and you have to fold the sides because we're not professionals and we don't want our mixture to spill from the sides. Carefully tuck in the both sides and then continue your wrapping until you're done with this. It's actually very simple and you can do it. This is what a shawarma should look like when you're done wrapping. Now guys, let's take a closer look at the wrapping process. First off, you put your sauce and coat the whole shawarma bread evenly with your sauce. Again, this will help to keep your wrap safe when you put it on the pan. Next, you put your chicken and veggies mixture. Careful not to overcrowd the wrap. Then you put your sausages. I'm using two for this particular wrap. Wrap carefully and when you've done the first roll, it's time for you to tuck in the sides to prevent any spillage when you put it on the pan. When you've tucked in the two sides, you can now wrap it carefully until the last one. This is what your shawarma should look like when you are done wrapping. Then put your skillet on the fire. You can use a regular frying pan if that's what you have. Grease it lightly and then put your shawarma. Brown lightly on each side and be careful not to let them burn. Check regularly and flip when it's brown. And guys, do not forget the other side. I like my shawarma to have a little bit of a crunch. Making shawarma is really easy if you follow the steps that I've given you. And guys, there you have it. Your very own homemade Nigerian chicken shawarma. This is what your shawarma should look like when they are ready. Guys, if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. I post lifestyle vlogs and occasionally you have food content here. Thank you guys for watching. Did you find this recipe simple to follow? Please drop a comment to encourage me.